Hi, this is Joni, holistic health teacher, coach, and consultant. I promised you, and I promised myself, that I'd challenge myself with these offerings to serve up a few more recipes. I'm not really a recipe girl, which I spoke on in an earlier video. I live a pretty transient life, and so I generally pull recipes that are super simple, super healthy, but super delicious. It just works for my lifestyle, and it might work for yours too. So one offering I gave up prior was to consult with food52.com. I love them. It's a open source style recipe offering where people can submit recipes. So that's a great place to look for something new and different than perhaps what you normally make. But today I'm offering up a winter root veggie mashup. I've been making this a lot. It's a kind of one of my easy go-tos in the wintertime because it's simple. It includes chopping up a bunch of vegetables, putting them in a dish, throwing it in the oven, done and done. So I make it all the time. Like I just said, this time of year, we really want to lean into eating seasonally. So root vegetables, warm foods that are go down a little bit easier on our throats when it's cold and dry and warm our bellies and our bodies, right? So again, keeping it simple and thinking about nature and how we as humans are part of nature and work with nature. These are the vegetables that taste best this time of year as well. That's kind of a whole nother topic that I learned working with high-end chefs in the States, high-end restaurants, learning how they work with the farmers and cook seasonally. So today we're talking about a winter root veggie mashup. I'll go ahead and post the recipe below, but really quickly, glass baking dish, layer some olive oil in the base. I prep garlic ahead of time usually, but you can just chop up some garlic. You can leave the pods whole or dice them fine if you'd like. Layer those in the pan. Onion, just dice that guy up, throw it in. Then I usually layer dark leafy greens and put another little coat of olive oil just because, it breaks up the more coarse vegetables if you use kale, but you can use kale or spinach or collard greens or whatever speaks to you. And then I layer beets. I love golden and red beets. These are fantastic for adrenal fatigue issues, which is why I try to eat a lot of them. My acupuncturist and nutritionist turned me on to those guys. Even 10 years later, I'm still trying to combat an adrenal issue that popped up. Broccoli or some other green veggie, I try to get a couple of dark cruciferous greens in there. Carrots, mushrooms sometimes, depending. And just a word to the wise, those white button mushrooms that you can buy in pretty much any grocery store, they don't actually have a lot of nutritional value. So you want to lean into shiitakes or criminis are a little bit more affordable and kind of dense and do well in this dish. So find one of those and just dice it all up. And you can use parsnips or taro or, you know, there are a lot of other root vegetables that you can throw in to your liking. And then I tend to layer a little bit of maca. So this is an adaptogen, and I've spoken on those prior, but we'll lean into adaptogens more on a later video. A little bit of maca. This is a root from the Peruvian Andes. It's I buy it from Nativas Organics. I'll link that below as well. It's a powder format. It's really great for balancing stress levels. It's great for libido. It's great for hormonal mood swings in women who are heading into menopause. And it just generally bolsters resiliency in the body. It's a little bit pungent, slightly nutty, slightly malty. But yeah, so sometimes I'll just sprinkle a little, you know, and mix it in. It's a really great item to use in smoothies and soups and warm drinks. You can even throw it in your pancake batter and you'll never know it's there. A few ideas for you on the maca. That's M-A-C-A, maca. So this is the veggie mashup dish. Top into those root vegetables. Eat with the seasons. And if you're inclined, eating with seasons, there's another video where I talk about that, eating seasonally, and that should be popping up right about now. So you can click on that and just learn a little bit more about what that's all about. Just basics. So enjoy eating seasonally, effectively, and efficiently. I'm all about, you know, quick 30 to 45 minute meals. Bake it on 350 for about 30 to 45 minutes. I'm at a higher altitude generally in the winter, so things take a little bit longer to cook. But, you know, just mix it up. You can stir it halfway through, kind of see where it's at, and go from there. So I hope you enjoy this video. I hope this helps you eat seasonally, eat healthy. Those sweet potatoes are delicious for, you know, potatoes are great, but sweet potatoes are delicious. They're a little bit more nutritious. And if you have a little bit of a sweet tooth and you're trying to lay off of sweets, eating vegetables that are naturally sweet will help you do that. It's all about training those taste buds, reacclimating them. And yeah, I think that's good for now. So have a great day. Enjoy your root veggies and play out there in the outdoors and take some time to forget about all this insanity going on in the world and take care of yourself. Thanks again for being here and be well.